السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'a, we present to you the daily Nasiha, and today with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jalla, we focus on the 11th of Sha'ban. It was on the 11th of Sha'ban, the year 1222 after Hijrah, corresponding to 14 September 1807 Gregorian calendar, the signing of the Treaty of Dimnahur took place between Muhammad Ali, the governor of Egypt, and the English, the British. This treaty granted Muhammad Ali Basha total autonomy over Egypt. Now we need to analyze all these situations. Misr, Egypt is called Misr, mentioned various places in the Noble Quran. Udkhulu Misra insha'Allahu Aminin. That you, the family of Nabi Yusuf alayhi salatu salam, you enter Egypt insha'Allah, Almighty Allah willing, Aminin, with safety, security. So we find it is the land of prophets and messengers. Nabi Musa alayhi salam was there. Nabi Harun alayhi salatu salam was there. And we find that, remember, the Pharaoh, the tin pot dictator, so he tried every trick, but Almighty Allah humiliated him. And let Nabi Musa, Nabi Harun alayhi salatu salam be victorious. We see similarly with Nabi Yusuf alayhi salatu salam. His brothers dumped him, Allah forbid, right in the well. And then they sold him as a slave. And so many things, vicissitudes, ups and downs of life he went through. And lo and behold, he becomes the ruler of Egypt. But the lesson he teaches humanity, that Fatir as-samawati wal-ard, Ya Allah, you are the creator of the heavens and the earth. Anta waliyyi fi dunya wal-akhirah. Ya Allah, you are my protector in this world and the year after. So you have a taste of everything. But the greatest taste is the love for Almighty Allah and the love for Jannat al-Firdaus al-A'la. So he, Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam, begs Almighty Allah, chapter 12, verse 101, Tawaffani muslima wa alhiqni bisalihin. O Almighty Allah, let me die and pass away with Iman and Islam, and unite me with the pious and devout servants, Ya Allah. Imagine, even there he makes dua like that. So here we see that the British, who were proud and arrogant people, and they would say the British Empire is so magnificent that the sun never sets, but everywhere they were stealing, occupying the lands of the people and the places they colonized. CA, Egypt also, India also, so many countries in Africa also. So that is what they did. And you will see primarily is the white man who's doing this. Either he is subjugating the blacks, either subjugating the Indians, other subjugating other people. So why? Whether it is the French, they also came there, Napoleon and so forth. So we must read all this history and remember that their imperialistic policy. And today they don't invade your country with their army. They invade their country with the media. They will export and send all their movies, their culture, their systems. And our people, you look at the Arab world, you look at the Muslim world, total turmoil. We can't present a single Muslim country today and say that this is Islam, this is the Sharia. Not one. Yes, we have Muslim countries with Muslim majority, but we do not have a single Islamic country. Is that not an indictment upon us when we say we are 1 billion Muslims? So why? Because we suffer from the inferiority complex and we think that white is right and the West is best and laughable. So that is a huge failing on our part collectively. So let us change the status quo and say Islam is the best and we want to share it with the rest. So that is how we become ambassadors of Islam and show them from their own history that the crimes they committed, whether in Egypt or Algeria, more than 150 years occupation by the French. May Almighty Allah protect the Muslim countries, Arab countries, and all of us, irrespective of where we live. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.